Hello, ladies and lizards. Welcome back to Super Mario World, Super Mario Advance 2. What do you mean, I just said lizards? If you're not a lizard, what are you even doing here? Anyway, sunken ghost ship. But first, let's take a look at the overworld map. The true overworld map, to see that everything has been done. This is the final level on the general overworld map that we need to clear. And it's the gateway towards the final world in the game. Even though we've seen that final world a couple of times already, because a lot of pathways in other worlds, World 2, in World 6, and of course a Star Road that gives you a glimpse of it. Because of that, we've already seen it a crap load of times, but still. Now we're actually going there. This crashed airship from Mario 3, possibly even Wendy's, because of she being so close to this one. And this has actually been taken over by ghosts now, and getting all the dragon coins is annoying, but not undoable here. One little thing about that is that they are all in the final room, so don't start looking for them here. This room is not that hard, you just need to pay attention to where the ghosts appear. Eventually, starting from this point, after the Eeries appear, which are the Yoshi ghosts, they're called Eeries. Once they appear, they stop appearing. Right, let's not get hit by this circle of boos. Come on, hurry up. In a speedrun, I will just run my way through this, take the hit. But no, we're not doing that here. Because of the dragon coins, I actually need that cape. Right, grab the star here. You can use the star here to grind on for lives on Koopas. This is the reason I need the cape, because the dragon coins here appear in the middle of this freefall. And the cape makes it a little bit easier to find them, because you can slow down your fall. Most of them are on the left of this area, so that's the way I remember getting all of them. Falling down slowly will make sure you don't miss them. The final one should be in the mid. No. I am surprised I got them all first try. I am really surprised. I don't remember grabbing the third one. I'll see that in editing. I thought I missed one already, but I see I have five, so. Right, here's the end, but you can go down here in the water. Oh, let's not go down too far. Because there's a couple of 1-ups hidden in here, I think. Oh, there they are. Which drift down, so if you're fast enough, you can find them. And this question is what you need to grab in order to finish the course. This mysterious little question block. Which will make the gateway towards the final world appear. A rock shaped in Bowser's face. I want a rock shaped in Bowser's face. I would live there. Right, we've been on the edges of this world a couple of times, but now we're finally actually in the Valley of Bowser. Let's go into the very first world immediately. You're stuck. Because I was a jerk and I got the Red Switch Palace, so now you're stuck. Poor guys. Right, there's a dragon coin in here, I think. You need to get rid of these blocks. You can make the Charge and Chuck do the rest. And yeah, there's a dragon coin here. I was pretty sure there was. It's a dead end otherwise, so you need to double back here. And now you're stuck. And I'm not the one to blame for it, you did it all yourself. But you're one of those idiot enemies that don't stop whenever you get to an edge. Like a Goombas and green Koopa Troopas. The big Monty Moles can be fun. They have sunglasses and everything, so. And I'm a big fan of wearing sunglasses myself, so. Even though you have no idea what I look like, at least most people don't. I know two of you do know what I look like, so. I'm not really talking about you guys, but all the other guys, you may know my me, because I do have my me shown off in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe and Mario Maker and everything, and you know my me also wears sunglasses, so that you can see. I am definitely a fan of sunglasses. It's one of the most cool accessories people can use. I definitely am one who does that. Well, this is a course that can be annoying. It's a little bit maze-like. You can go bottom path, top path, middle path. You can go everywhere here, so that's what I'm doing here, because I do want to go everywhere. Not so much to show everything off, but because I am pretty sure. Funny business. Because I am pretty sure they're going to hide dragon coins everywhere. Let's take a quick look everywhere. I've only found two so far, so. Oh, there's a third one. You, my friend, are pretty funny to kill this way. Right, that's three. That's blocked off because of the yellow switch. So there's no way they're placing dragon coins there. They're not that mean. Oh, there's number four. So I'm pretty sure I'm on schedule. There's one more. I can't pass that. Mean. Right. This is a fine, which you can take upwards. Right, good thing you took care of yourself there. I don't think there's anything there. Let's go back. Let's get hit by a charging truck, because why not? Let's not die to this guy. That would be a waste. There we are. Alright, luckily I can clear this course in one try. Bye. Yeah, there's nothing else here. I'm pretty sure there's still a bonus area, even though we got all of the dragon coins. Yeah. That was one of these. Nothing too special. Let's see if I can get more lives. I've broken 300 lives already, I see. Is it really that bad? 313. Oh, you got thrown back all the way to the middle section of this course. That's a pretty big dead end. That's a pretty big part I need to replay then. Come on, hurry up. I'm pretty sure I can still make it, but 50 seconds is scaring me a little bit now. So let's run towards the end now. Bye. And let's take this with me, because I don't have any extra power-ups anymore. So I'll use this block to give me a reserve mushroom at least. Right, there's the first course. Got all the secrets here, so no repeat necessary here. Valley of Bowser 2 is a big red dotted course, so this is going to be, first of all, a large course, and second of all, a secret exit course. Ow. This is one of the most annoying courses because of the bats appearing at the top of the screen. You can't always see them coming, so I always get hit a lot here. They're called swoopers, by the way. I keep calling them bats, but they're basically still the swoopers, even though they don't really look like them, in all honesty. They don't even have the purple color scheme they're supposed to have. Alright, quick note on this course, though. You cannot grab 5 dragon coins in this course, normally. I will show off where all of the dragon coins you can grab all are. But remember, there are not 5 dragon coins in this course. I still don't know why not. There's a hidden block here. Come on. Oh, there you are. I still don't know why. Even in this remake, there are still only 3 dragon coins in this course. And the only way to get 5 of them, because it is of course still possible, that is with those wings you just saw. This is a section Yoshi cannot get past. If you bring Yoshi here, you will die. I can make that. I know what I'm doing, don't get scared. Normally you need to be careful not to get crushed by the walls here because of the moving platforms. But there are a couple of niches you can skip. Even this one. I've been doing that for years, so I know what I'm doing. And here's the third and final dragon coin in the course. you cannot grab anymore, because there simply aren't anymore. But in the bonus area, you end up whenever you take the Yoshi wings. That area does have 4 Dragon Coins, so that is actually required in order to clear the game, or clear the level 100% for the Dragon Coins. Of course, in the original game, not necessary. The game does not keep track of which levels you have collected all the Dragon Coins, so that is not required for 100% there. But in this version of the game, it is required, so... But that coin in the first room and the 2 hidden in this moving platform section is actually the only 3 in the regular level. Wait for the moving platform to go all the way up, because of course there are secrets here. Go up here for this course's secret exit. This is where it is hidden here. Which will take you to the Valley Fortress. Which is once again a shortcut towards the final castle, as you can see. And might as well clear this secret pathway off immediately. That's always the way I play. I'm not going to change that this late in the game, this late in my life. After playing it this way for over 25 years. Once again, don't get scared by them. It's a little bit the same as the very first room in Wendy's castle. A little bit more tricky, I think. This is definitely a harder room. Right here you need to be quick, because... as you can see, you won't make it if you're too slow. Just make sure you have enough power-ups in order to survive. Right, and now the hard part comes, because like in Wendy's castle, they start moving around faster the further you get into the room. Maybe make it even more tricky because of having a Podoboo here. This one is annoying to get. Go, yeah. I don't think it's possible to get that Dragon Coin without getting hit if you immediately go towards the next platform. Right. I got them all. The final Reznor in the game. Even these guys get a little bit harder the further you get. As you can see, they breathe out fire a little bit more often than the first time we met them. But they're still basically the same. Nothing too hard about them. You should not get scared by them. Right, and this will take you towards a course called Backdoor, which is actually a shortcut toward the final boss. More on that later, I will not be treating this right now. I'm just saying, this is not just a different entrance towards the final castle aesthetically, it's a little bit more than that. But more on that later, because we're obviously not there yet. We were just clearing the pathway towards it, the final castle itself. Does not get any coverage quite yet. We are not at the end of the game yet. Ow! Alright, now it's a simple matter of getting towards the end of the level again. We've already seen most of this, so... fast forward time. I'm not cutting it, it's way more fun to show this section of fast forward. That's gonna be hilarious. Well, there's one way to make a speedrunner's nightmare become more fun. Just record a section that you're forced to do slow-paced and speed up the footage. It'll still go fast. Oh, me. Me thinking I'm funny. Right, this is the normal exit. We were almost there, as you may see. The secret exit for this course was quite close to the normal exit. And this is actually a course I'm going to have to do a third time in order to grab all of the Dragon Coins. I did not get any. Remember the time I tried to actually get nothing? Where it didn't work out? Now I was no longer trying. And then it works out. Is that really how it works, game? Oh, video games. Trying things, not succeeding at trying things. And the moment you stop trying to do things, you still manage to get it then. That is apparently how things work. Right, we once again are dealing with a ghost house with two exits. So, remember to do both. This room is annoying though, you actually have to press a P switch, then a pathway of blocks appears. Which you can use. Oh, Dragon Coin. Which you need to use to go either left or right towards a door. I'm going to go left first because I am collecting Dragon Coins here. And there's nothing too much to do in this room yet, so let's go back. And now take the right pathway. Grab the Dragon Coin here. And go to the very final door here. You need to be fast for that. Of course. Why am I not surprised? Don't go through this door. This is towards the exit. And this one too. Go through this door. It'll take you to this room again. Right, let's try again. You actually need to go to that final door if you want all the Dragon Coins. Right, let's... Oh, there's another one here! Huh, good thing I tried to go for a running start, because... I would have forgotten that one. Right, let's try again. Hopefully I'm quicker now. Before the P-switch runs out. There we go. Right, what's in here? Another hidden room. Oh, there's a Dragon Coin here as well. And one up here. Oh, it wouldn't have mattered if I missed that other one. There's six Dragon Coins in this course, apparently. Right, grab you. And grab an extra one. Right, here is a coin snake, which you can use to go upwards. P-switch is going to run out because of me having to collect those Dragon Coins. But there's actually another way up here. As you can see, there is a key here. Normally, you're supposed to use the coin snake to direct it up here and use the P-switch to step on the coins, but I can fly. And if you fly, press downward the moment you enter that niche, you can actually duck your way into that little niche. That's usually how I do it. Yeah, I know how to cheese this game way too much. Don't worry, that'll change in later Mario games. I have not played as much as this one, or just other games in general. We're just dealing with a game I have played over a million times, so I know all the tricks in it. But that does not mean I'm not going to cover those games for the Let's Play channel. Those will also get their turn. Me knowing all the tricks, it's more show-off than a playthrough, in all honesty. Right, and now let's quickly do the normal exit. We know where that was, I already indicated that. If you go through these doorways, the third one or the fourth one is where the normal exit is. For some reason, there are two doors right after each other. I don't know why. It's just the case. Door number three or door number four for the exit. Right, let's go to Valley of Bowser 3 now. I will return for that second one. I know I'm skipping out on it, but we need to do the Yoshi Wings section in order to get all of the Dragon Coins, and I'm simply waiting until we get a Yoshi. And I'm pretty sure this course is also not going to give me one, because remember, I have not really talked about that again the moment I declared that challenge, but I'm also trying to not use the Top Secret Area or any other courses to go back to and collect some power-ups. I'm not doing that. I'm simply returning to old courses if I still have something to clear off, like an exit, or in this case, collecting Dragon Coins. I'm pretty sure this pipe, yeah, is another one of these bonuses. Man, I'm doing terrible on this one. I thought this was easier and I missed all of them. Is it because I was trying to do it with the shell? Man, I'm trying to be fancy. this is where you end up. You don't really miss too much. I'm still carrying that shell. let's lose it now. Thank you for the power-up. Right, Luigi's annoying fireball physics are going to screw me over here, I think. Ah, I knew it! Why is Luigi's fireball mechanic so weird? The bounce is a lot different than Mario's. And because of that, I can't aim anymore. And these platforms are not really noteworthy. You see how they work. A counter starts running, and once it's out, the platform falls. They can be either 1 or 4. They speak for themselves, they don't really need an explanation, that's why I skipped over them. Right, stay on the top in order to get the 1-up. And that should be it. Right, next course will give us a Yoshi, I'm pretty sure. This one, the final normal level in the game. Valley of Bowser 4. So after this one, we can finally checkmark that course we missed with the Dragon Coins. This introduces us to a new kind of charge and chuck, one with shovels and digging up rocks. The rocks that can hurt you, by the way, so... Otherwise, they wouldn't be here. That would be a pretty weird thing, that an enemy is nothing more than a static, that it actually does something, but that something that it does doesn't really hurt you. That would be weird. And it could have just made it like Lemmy's balls or anything, that you get knocked back by them. Or the snowballs in Mario Maker 2. Not an effect that hurts you, but an effect that hinders you. That could also be a thing, but that would do absolutely nothing. That would be really weird. Right, we're getting... Come on, jump on him. Blue Yoshi again. There's two ways of going down. You can also take that left pathway. That won't give you a death. There's no endless pit down there. Come on. Stupid trampoline. Why am I even bringing the trampoline? Well, now I'm definitely bringing the trampoline. I'm making a challenge out of this. Bring the trampoline for absolutely no reason. Come on, Yoshi. Swallow it. Or eat it. Don't swallow it, because I want it. Still don't know why, but I'm taking it. This, eh? I'm pretty sure this is something they added in this version. It's not in the original version, I'm pretty sure. I wasn't paying attention! Yoshi swallowed the trampoline! Challenge failed! Now, here's a challenge I don't really mind failing. As long as I keep my no death run. Which is still going! Right. Yeah, I'll do the secret pathway first. It is hidden in the wall, as you can see, so you're actually required to bring Yoshi to the end of the stage in order to get that secret exit, if that isn't obvious. And a normal exit is right beside it, so you can't really miss that. Alright, sorry about that. Something... my computer panicked a little bit. Well, it doesn't really matter. I think I still need to close off, of course, but... Yeah, 20 minutes have passed. I'll do that dragon coin hunting in the next course. I'll do that next time. Don't really have to do it now. Yeah, something went wrong with my computer, but I don't think I lost any footage. So, I'll see that in a minute. Hopefully, I still got my footage. I think I do, actually. But in case I still have my footage, I am going to say this is going to be it for today. I have completed enough courses. So, next time we will continue. Now I have a Yoshi, so we will finish off Valley of Bowser 2, where I still need to collect all the Dragon Coins, which I'm forced to do through the Yoshi Wings. And then I'll do the normal exit here, the castle, and finish off the game? Question mark? Emphasis on the question mark. Anyway, thanks for watching, and see you next time. This is Treeks, out.